What if every idea you saved unlocked 100 more? Sounds pretty awesome, right? Well, that's exactly what Sublime promises. Now, this isn't just another note-taking or bookmarking tool. It's more of a living network of ideas. So I've been using this for a few weeks now, and I think it has great potential for creative discovery and extending my own knowledge system. So in this video, I'll show you how it works, why I think it's different, and how you can put it to work for yourself. I'm Adam with Productivity Academy, and let's get into this. You can see it in the background. If you would like some more information, you can find the link down below. Just click on that, go check it out. They've got a lot of interesting information. They've got, of course, a nice video here, but what we want to get started with is just going to log in and jump right into it. So let's do that. All right, so we're now logged in, and just a quick overview, and before we jump into a bunch of different things here I want to share with, but you know, a little bit of background on Sublime. So this is a tool designed for, you know, knowledge-driven professionals, creative, to collect and connect ideas in kind of a more dynamic way. So I think it's important also to kind of share, and it took me a little while to wrap my mind around how this differs from some traditional tools. So this is less a static knowledge base like Notion, Evernote, something like that. It's also much more of a discovery engine as much as kind of a storage tool and holding what you find. I think a good way to say this is like it's built for serendipity, which I'll show. And you know, every idea here connects to many more. And this ties in, I wrote down their core tagline. Is save one thing, discover 100 more. And to show you right off the bat what that means, let's click on this. We've got a line here I had highlighted from Shane Parrish in The Great Mental Models about just something I went through when going through the book. So, you know, it's not that like important of a highlight, but I think this will showcase how this goes. So haven't clicked on this before, this particular highlight, but we're talking about avoiding problems. It's by Shane Parrish. It's about the great mental models. And when we click on this, we get a lot of related highlights or notes. And see, these can come from your own savings, but also from others. And we can see down here, we can see who it's been added by, that there's other people who are publicly allowing public access to see this. We can look at odds of success, avoid the risk of ruin. We've got just, you know, a ton of different things here. This is great, you know, mental models again. We've got just all of this different stuff going on here. And this is what they mean about discovering 100 more. Perhaps we want to go down here and let's find one that looks interesting. Never take a risk that will do you incompletely. Like, oh, okay, well, risk, that's a really interesting idea behind these mental models and avoiding problems, right? Having an infinite or, you know, a downside that will take you to zero and take you out of the game, whether that's financial, whether that's life, whatever that is, you want to really avoid those situations. We could click into that and start seeing what's going on here. What are some ideas in this area? Who are the people that talked about these? And you know, what have other people said about them? So I think that that almost immediately really shows kind of some of the power of this. So let's go back and again, kind of share some more about this and how this works. So of course, to get started, you need to put information into the system, right? Otherwise it's a bit of a blank slate. Luckily, they make this really easy. There is a Chrome extension. I'm not going to bore you to death and show you how to go about installing a Chrome extension, but it's easy. You do that, and then it's like the web clipping where you can use that to start importing information into your account. You can see over here on the left, I have imported and have set up syncing between Readwise and Kindle. So that is going to pull information in. I could actually probably remove the Kindle because everything for me goes through Readwise. So coming into here is just super easy, and I got everything in there almost hands off. It was extremely easy to do. And the manual entry, you could just add something yourself if you need to manually put something on there. Now, I think one of the questions you, or at least I was asking myself when I did this was, well, I see other people's stuff. Is everyone gonna see all of my stuff? And you can make them private. It's up to you whether you want. You can see on everything I've imported, by default, it is private. And then you could go through, you could change that if you want to, you could share certain things, and you can, of course, start to group things, okay? And that's what collections are over here. You can create a new collection. You can look at your existing ones, and these are just ones I set up quickly. I obviously haven't deeply set this up, but I think like this is one that is a good example. I have it, it's locked, as in it's private, and it's just great writing. This is a tag I very recently started and just wanted to start collecting snippets of great writing that I see that either I think the words evoke a certain feeling that I think is neat. It's just an interesting concept. And right now it's populated by David Mintel books that I have recently read in the last like 2 months. I think that this is a good way too. And you can keep those private, you can share them. And just like you can do with all of your highlights, you can add these filters, you can shuffle them, or you can search through them. So let's go into the filters a little bit more and go back to home and all cards. All right, if we go through here, we can shuffle. This just does a random shuffling. And let's just stop there and say we want to sort. This is really cool. So we could sort. There's a lot of just basic sorting, newest, oldest, all of that by types. And then this gets interesting to me too. We can look at imported, not imported, created by you, has notes, no notes, private or not. There's a lot of granularity you can do kind of behind the scenes. So I think it's very simple. It's very minimal to get started with, and I like that. But behind the scenes, there is more you can do to really get granular, get specific, and do more if that's what you want to do with it. So let's go in and let's find a highlight we like, and let's explore some interesting I'm just gonna choose this. Protect your skin from the sun. Let's see what this unsurfaces. And let's see if we can find some people. Might not have been the best one. That might not be a lot of people saving information about that. Let's try something more. Okay, let's do that. That's a Tim Ferriss highlight. I'm sure there's gonna be people sharing stuff. Let's see if we could, okay, there we go. So we have somebody, let's say you start seeing someone whose information you're really interested in, you can follow them to uncover more of the information if you wanted to. Again, I believe I was going through here, I looked at a longevity highlight I had taken, and I looked for related ideas and comments and these notes, and found one. Oh, of course, Packy McCormick had shared a bunch of that, and he looks to be using the app. So I thought that was really interesting. I'm like, oh, well, Packy puts out some really interesting information. He researches a lot of different neat areas that I'm interested in, so I may want to follow that so I see that information. So let's head back to the homepage. And the third thing here is Canvas. Okay, and I think that this is an interesting idea. I'm gonna be totally upfront. I really haven't needed to use this. I just know it exists, saw it. I see where it's going. I think it's a neat idea. I watched part of the introduction video. If you're here, by the way, you need to double click to get this to play. Or you could just check it out if you probably Google or go to YouTube and look at Getting Unstuck with Sublime Canvas. You could look into that, and you've got a lot of the standard kind of whiteboard features that you can add content, and they go into it and show about, you know, arranging your content, adding things on there. And I just think, again, it's a great idea, but I haven't had a chance to really get into it. And I think potentially for collecting your ideas and to solidify things instead of the kind of discovery and outward phase where you're collecting ideas and looking at all these different things, that this would then be where maybe you can start to bring things together and connect the dots, just like they say. So cool idea, something worth checking out, I think, but for me, it's not the prime reason that I would be using Sublime. So having now looked through all of this, looked at these different ways we can use this, the uncovering, the finding, related ideas, you know, I think instead of just having a place where you're kind of dumping things and it's a reference, which has its own very important purpose, but helping to discover new ones and connect related ideas is super powerful, and it is really neat, and is, I think, going to be something that we're going to see spreading across more tools. I'm surprised that this hasn't been more ubiquitous, and to see it now is like, oh yeah, right, like it's here, of course. Like, why wasn't this something before? I think that this is a really neat you know, I guess I'll call it a feature, but I think that this is something that can really help as you're researching, as you're uncovering new ideas, as you're learning new things. So beyond that, I think who, you know, would really get the most out of this, if you enjoy idea discovery, you want to extend your knowledge in areas that you're looking at, you know, if you're already using tools like Readwise, you're saving highlights on your Kindle, you're saving content, and you find yourself diving into areas and learning and, you know, or just wanting to refresh knowledge and uncover new areas, I think that this, you know, applies to you, and that is a huge area. Of course, it's creative professionals, it's people that spend time online, but I think it's an interesting idea, definitely worth exploring. And I think that, you know, if you prefer more of a rigid structure, then, you know, this may not be the tool for you to check out. And I'm going to keep using this and kind of sharing what I find, what I enjoy, and how things go. But after now using this for a few weeks, definitely wanted to share initial impressions and what I think is a really interesting tool and something kind of new that people may be interested in and getting some great ideas and use out of. If you have any questions, comments, leave them below. If you like this review and you want to see others on other tools, you can, of course, subscribe to the channel. Other than that, hope you have a great day. The link to the app is down below. Check it out if it seems interesting. And thanks again for watching.